Alright, today's lesson is 6.6, day one. We're talking about parallel and perpendicular lines. Now, parallel and perpendicular lines is a concept that you already understand, but we are taking it up to the algebra level. Parallel lines are two lines in the same plane that never intersect. A real life example would be train tracks, right? Train tracks, they never intersect. Because if they do, you have a problem, right? Perpendicular line. Oh, by the way, that is the symbol for parallel line. Line L is parallel to line M. Perpendicular lines are lines that intersect and form right angles. This is the notation for perpendicular. It is an upside down capital T. Line L is perpendicular to line M. Okay. I will expect you to use that notation and understand what you mean. All right, now, lines that have the same slopes are parallel. Because think about it, isn't slope rise over run? If you've got two parallel lines, aren't they going to have the same rise over run? Lines whose slopes are negative reciprocal or perpendicular. Negative reciprocals are this. My slope of line one is 2/3. What's the negative reciprocal of 2/3? Nope. -3/2. Flip it and change the sign. Reciprocal. Flip it and change the sign. So these two lines are perpendicular. A quick tip note on comparing perpendicular lines. Two lines are perpendicular if the product of their slope is -1. Okay? Negative reciprocal means when you multiply it by that number, you get -1. So, let's do another one. What if I said the slope of my first line is -8? What would the slope of every perpendicular line in the world be? Yep. Perpendicular slope for line 2 would be 1/8. Flip it, change the sign. Negative reciprocal. Alright, here we go. Here, we have a line that has a slope of -3/4. What is the slope of every parallel line going to be? -3/4. And what will the perpendicular lines have? Flip it and change the sign. 4/3. Good. We've got a slope of 7. Parallel line slope will be 7. Perpendicular lines will be -1/7. If we've got -1, what will the parallel slope be? And what will the perpendicular be? 1. If we've got -1/5, what will the slope, our parallel be? Perpendicular. Okay, now here we go. Slope is 0. What will the parallel line be? 0, and what will perpendicular be? What's 1 over 0? Undefined. You can never have 0 under. When 0 is under, it is undefined. So, undefined, parallel would be undefined. What would perpendicular be? Correct. And, doesn't it make sense? What kind of line has slope 0? Horizontal. And this is vertical. So aren't horizontal and vertical perpendicular to each other? Then, determine if the following lines are parallel, perpendicular, or neither. Well, we need to know their slopes. of this first line, Kimmy? Correct, because it's in slope-intercept form. So the slope here is -1/3. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, because it is in slope-intercept form. Now my friend, is it so easy to look at that other one? No, why not? Because it's not in slope-intercept form. What form is that ish? Standard-ish, because I could really deny everything like this. But I call that standard anyway. It's standard-ish. Now, you cannot, do not look at this and tell me the slope is 2 because it's what's in front of x. No, it's not, because it is not in slope-intercept form. So, how do I get this in slope-intercept form? Jane? Well, I would do something else first. Do you want to get y alone? So how would I get y alone? No. Subtract 2x. So 6y equals -2x+12. Right? And now what? Correct. So I'm going to have y equals -1/3x+2. Are those two lines parallel, perpendicular, or neither? Guys, what is the slope of this line? The slope here is -1/3. Those lines are parallel because their slopes are no joke. They are the same. They are parallel. Good. Let's look at this pair. What is the slope of the second line? The slope here is 3/4. Can I look at this one and tell you what the slope is right away? No, we need to transform it. Jane, what do I do to transform this? Yes! So, 8y equals -6x-24. Then what? Divide every single thing by 8. So y equals what? -3/4x. -3. What's the slope of this line? Are these lines parallel, perpendicular, or neither?
Parallel.
Neither. Okay, guys. Okay. Now you're killing me. Are these two numbers the same? No, so they're not parallel. Are these negative reciprocal? No, so they're not perpendicular, so it is neither. What? Hey, what would this have to be for these to be perpendicular? If this was -4/3, then we would say perpendicular. All right, now, guys, listen. Write an equation in slope-intercept form for the line that contains the point 5, 1 and is parallel to this line. What do we know about parallel lines? Their slope is the same. So, what is the slope of this line? Okay, so the slope of line 1 is 3/5. So, what will the slope of the parallel line be? So, here's my slope, and it goes through this point. What equation do I need to use if I've got a point and a slope? Point slope. So, y minus y sub 1 equals m times y x minus x sub 1. give me the equation. Chase. What's M? 3/5. Now, are we done with this problem? No, because look, it said they want your answer in slope intercept form. So, what do I need to do here to transform into slope intercept form? But what do I need to do? Y minus 1 equals 3/5 x minus 3. How do I finish getting into slope intercept? So y equals 3/5 x minus 2. Okay. Write an equation in slope intercept form for the line that contains the point 2, -6 and is perpendicular to this line. Now, what is the slope of this line? 3. Okay, the slope of that line is 3. Mind you, you might have some in your homework. You actually have to transform in the slope-intercept form first to find the slope. But, so, we want a line that is perpendicular to that. So what will the perpendicular slope be, Kayla? Correct. -1/3. It is the negative reciprocal. Flip it and change its sign. So now I'm using that point and that slope. Who can give me the equation and point slope? Kimmy. I like the way you did that. Instead of writing y minus -6, she went right to y plus 6 equals. -1/3 times the quantity. Kimmy, finish it out. X minus what? Make sure you use the perpendicular slope. Not the parallel slope. We're going perpendicular, so it's a negative reciprocal. Transform it. So y plus 6 uses distributive property. -1/3 x plus 2/3. I'm going to subtract 18/3. Why did I do that? Why did I subtract 18/3 from both sides?
Because
16 and it is equal to 18. Well, it's common. Common denominator. Can I need a common denominator? This is 18/3 6. I'm basically subtracting 6. So, I've got y equals -1/3 x, what, -16/3. Okay, find the equation. Let's do this line here. What are the two things I need to write an equation of a line? You need a point and a slope if you're going to do point slope form, or a slope and an intercept, right? Do I really have an intercept here? I mean, I do, but would I know what it is? So I'm going to do 2 points. So this point right here is what? -6, 1, and this point right here is -1, -3. So let's find the slope. -3 - 1 over -1 - -6 gives me what? -4, 6. So that's my slope, and I'm going to use this point. So y - 1 equals -4/5.